Here's another interesting rally for you. Now, we have one of the members of the Raleigh Roadster Club currently rebuilding a late 1980s black Raleigh Chiltern. So, I thought it was a good time to show the one that I did. This is by no means an original restoration. This is definitely a customised, upgraded and updated renovation. So, the bike is, as I said, a late 90s Chiltern, and black was the most popular colour for them. The deco's non-original, I'll come to that. It would have had a white Raleigh here and Chiltern on the chain guard and some grey and white stripes. This bike, actually, when I picked it up, it came with some racing handlebars, drop handlebars, that were turned upside down. And it had a mountain bike seat post in that was up here, so that obviously the rider was far too tall for the bike, and then modified it accordingly. The thing about these black Chilterns and a lot of the bikes from Raleigh of this era is they were early adopters of powder coating, and the paintwork was terrific. But for some reason the black would sometimes get some corrosion underneath it and bubble up from behind. This one wasn't so bad. So rather than take it all off to bare metal, which I normally would on a job like this, I flatted it off, repaired any areas that needed, and left the very hard paint on there. Because the brief for this bike was that it was going to be a classic rally for everyday use, hence the upgrades and updates. So it was for normal cycling, where the chap wanted the handling of a vintage rally, like the one that he rides as well, but something a great deal lighter than the Pashley Roadster Sovereign that he also owns. So really he wanted something like the Pashley that rode like the rally, and so that's what I tried to do. So as you can see, it's got a modern Dutch style look to it with the cream tyres, called Delta Cruisers. It's got alloy rims, alloy hubs, stainless spokes, and a Dutch parking lock you can see there, and the original factory fitted Raleigh carrier. The handlebar stem is the original type, but this is a new one, and the handlebars are a pair of actually Raleigh branded but not made by Raleigh alloy North Roads, the standard Sturmey Archer 3-speed shifter, and his ding dong bell. And another part of my brief was to install a bracket to fit the Dutch rear light. It used to have a horrible square reflector on there that was broken, so I fitted something a little bit that looked a little bit more like it belonged there. And graphics wise, obviously I took off the horrible ones, and I had a pair of these in some deco sets in the back of the shop, and they seem very appropriate. I really like them on there. You would otherwise see them on the chain guard of a late 60s Sports. And then just a heron on there, which seems to have come adrift slightly, and the heron on the rear mudguard. So there it is, it's quite a simple bike, this black Brooks B66. Very purposeful, very smart, and it rides beautifully, as we're going to find out now. The lights on this bike, I forgot to mention, are powered by a rear dyno hub. That's a Sturmey Archer AG hub, it's a 3-speed with generator. And the headlamp comes from a Dutch Gazelle. It was actually the standard fitting headlamp on my 2012 Gazelle. when I got it, I still had it in the drawer, so it found its forever home on here. As always, the bike's got the 22 tooth rear sprocket, which means easier pedalling up the hills, of which there are quite a few in its new home. And the owner reports it glides up them very well, if not effortlessly. What a nice place to be able to ride your bike.